Today we'll be understanding the basics of ballistic galvanometer. This is a common device that we use in our experiments with electricity and magnetism. And physically it looks like this. The apparatus in the lab we get is this kind of a black box, and a lamp and a scale arrangement is supplied along with it. So we will be discussing the physics of this galvanometer and the application of this lamp and scale arrangement. The galvanometer, which is used for estimating the quantity of charge flow through it, is called the ballistic galvanometer. And the working principle is that the deflection of the coil is directly proportional to the charge that passes through it. The galvanometer measures the majority of charge that passes through it in spite of the current. It is a sensitive galvanometer and is also commonly known as a mirror galvanometer. And why mirror has used, that you will come to know later on. Unlike a current measuring galvanometer, the moving part has a large moment of inertia, thus giving it a long oscillation period, and that is why it is called a ballistic one. It is really an integrator measuring the quantity of charge discharged through it. It can be either of the moving coil or moving magnet type. So for the construction is quite simple. The ballistic galvanometer consists of a coil of copper wire, which is round on a non-conducting frame of the galvanometer. The non-conducting frame is the iron core, and this is the copper coil. The phosphorus bronze wire suspends the coil between the north and south poles of the magnet. This is the blue, this blue colored is the phosphorus bronze wire. For increasing the magnetic flux, the iron core plates are placed within the coil. These are the iron core plates. The lower portion of the coil connects with the spring. The lower portion is connected to the spring, and this spring provides the restoring torque to the coil. This restoring torque is used to bring back this mirror into its original position. Whenever a current charge passes through it, this coil, it deflects, and which deflection is proportional to the amount of charge. And when the charge is closed, the passage is closed, then to bring back to its original position, this spring provides the necessary torque in the reverse direction. When the charge passes through the galvanometer, the coil starts moving and gets an impulse. And there is the charge through this coil. Under the influence of the magnetic field, there is a force generated, and the coil gets deflected, and when the coil gets deflected, the mirror also rotates. The impulse of the coil is proportional to the charges that passes through it, and the actual reading of the galvanometer is obtained by using the coil having a high moment of inertia. The moment of inertia means the body opposes the angular movement. If the coil has a high moment of inertia, then their oscillations are large, and thus accurate reading is obtained. The theory behind this: let us consider a rectangular coil having n number of turns placed in a uniform magnetic field. Let L be the length of the coil and B be the breadth of the coil. The area of the coil is simply length into breadth. When the current passes through the coil, the torque acts on it. The given expression determines the magnitude of the torque. So this is the magnitude of the torque that is generated under the influence of the magnetic field. Let the current flow through the coil for a very short duration, say dt, for the small time dt, then this torque for that time is given as NIVA into dt. If the current passing through the coil for t seconds, the expression now becomes, this was for dt, now for t, we will integrate it in the limits of 0 to small t. the QB, the total charge passed through the coil, the moment of inertia of the coil is given by I, and the angular velocity through omega. The expression gives the angular momentum of the coil is I omega. The angular momentum of the coil is equal to the force acting on the coil. So we balance the two equations. The kinetic energy deflects the coil through an angle theta, and this deflection is restored through the spring, like we have seen. And the restoring torque is half C theta square. And the kinetic energy is half L omega square. Now these is to completely balance the motion. These two should be equal, so we equate it, and simplifying, we get C theta square is equal to L omega square. The period of oscillation of the coil is given as T is equal to 2 pi under root L upon C. Squaring this equation and rearranging the terms, we get the value of L. Now we substitute this value of L in the above equation. We get this. On rearranging and simplifying, we get the value of the charge Q. This charge Q is proportional to the angle theta, and the rest of the quantities are constants for a particular set of experiments, like the magnetic field, the number of turns of the coil, the area of the coil, and the time. Keeping this in constant, we see that Q is proportional to theta. So the more the amount of charge that passes through the coil, the greater is the angle by which it is deflected. So this principle is used while measuring the charges from this balancing element. This is a common balancing elementometer that we see quite often in the lab. This is a spirit level, so and the ballistic element is leveled by the screws provided at the base. After removing the cover, we see that there is a phosphor bronze wire, and the mirror is attached to it. These are the support balancing wire for the mirror. This mirror is attached to the copper coil. This is the iron core. In the lab, this ballistic galvanometer is arranged like this. It is placed on the wall. There is a lamp and a scale arrangement provided with it. The light from the lamp is focused on the mirror, which after reflection gives the image on the scale provided. This is the light source. This is the mirror. Ballistic galvanometer. The image comes on this scale. This is adjusted. That the distance. This is this point. After reflection, there is a crosswire from where the readings can be noted. And the settings are such that the distance between the lamp and the ballistic galvanometer should be 1 meter. The focus of the lamp is such adjusted that the perfect spot on the scale is obtained when the distance is 1 meter. This is a perfect arrangement. Ballistic galvanometer, this is lamp, this is the scale. These are the circuit components that we want to study. Thank you for hearing.